climate change has already impacted our country in terms of water resources, agriculture production, and also loss of biodiversity and loss of our equipment, especially for those areas that are vulnerable to the drought and flooding, and also sea level rising.
Hello, gracious viewers, and welcome to this week's edition of Planet Earth, Our Loving Home, where we will be examining the impacts of climate change on the island nation of Timor-Leste, as well as hear from some of the country's top environmental officials regarding the steps the nation is taking to address this serious issue. Located in Southeast Asia to the northwest of Australia, the Democratic Republic of Timor-Leste includes the eastern half of Timor Island and other territories. Approximately 1.1 million people inhabit this splendid country, characterized by mountainous terrain and a tropical climate. Let us first hear from Mr. Adao Soares Barbosa, who is deeply involved in setting Timor-Leste's climate change policy.
My name is Adao Soares Barbosa. I am a national focal point for UN Convention on Climate Change. And then, as well as I'm acting as a climate change negotiator to UN. Besides that, I'm also acting as a national advisor for developing a strategic plan for the environment for 20 years. And I'm also acting as advisor for the Minister of Economy and Development as a climate change technical person to address the international issue of climate change.
We asked Mr. Soares Barbosa about the effects of climate change as seen in Timor-Leste.
We have El Nino. Every 4 years, we have a problem with drought and desertification. La Nino can result in some flooding, yeah. So during La Nina time, we have a lot of rain. So we have a high density of rain pattern. But for El Nino, every 4 years, we have a drought.
In the past 30 years, over 2.8 billion people have been affected by floods worldwide, with over 95% of them residing in Asia. Floods deeply impact families, homes, and livelihoods. Widespread crop damage caused by flooding can have an immensely negative effect on a nation's ability to feed itself and injures social welfare and a country's economy.
During 2009-2010, we do have some problems with flooding that affected at least 6,000 people in Timor-Leste. They need to be evacuated to safe place due to the problem of floodings. And then we also have a problem with our national agricultural production. In 2002-2003, we lost our corn production by 34%. Statistical data is indicating that we have a problem with drought and flooding, affecting our, food security and agricultural products in Timor-Leste. And we also have a problem with our bridges and road infrastructure. In Suai in 2007-2008, our bridge in Suai was damaged by flooding. Not only in Suai, even in Loes, even in Manatutu, even in Lalea, we have problem with, flooding that affected our bridges in Timor-Leste. And also landslides. Recently in Kilikai, thousands, they lost their infrastructure, they lost their houses, they lost their rice field, and also other crops. So this is very important for us. Yeah, that need to be addressed by developing appropriate actions at national and international levels.
Thank you. respected Australian oceanographer Dr. John Church, is part of the Marine and Atmospheric Research Division of the Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization, which is Australia's national science agency. He is an expert on sea level rise and has studied its effects on Asia and elsewhere.
The reasons for sea level rise are firstly, warming of the oceans. The oceans are absolutely central to climate change. If you want to understand climate change, you have to understand the oceans. They've absorbed a huge amount of heat. As they warm, they expand and sea level rises.
There are many islands in the Pacific, the Indian, who will all be impacted by sea level rise. And perhaps more important are the many deltas around the world where there are very large populations living right next to the coast. Not only is sea level rising, but the land in these regions is sinking also. These combined impacts will have very serious implications through the 21st century and beyond.
We also have a sea level rise problem. You know, when the previous government, the government of Indonesia, in the 1980s, they opened road along Pantai Kelapa. There were big separations between seawater and land, but now it's already impacted. And this road is already impacted by seawater, by wave. So this is indicating that we have a sea level rise problem as well.
A stark reality faced by many island nations right now is the danger of totally disappearing. On October 17, 2009, the government of the Maldives conducted a cabinet meeting entirely underwater, where the nation's president, His Excellency Mohamed Nasheed, and other top officials signed a document calling for all countries to take immediate action to reduce greenhouse gas emissions to protect low-lying nations.
Maldives is less than 1 meter above sea level. So if there is no action by 2020, Maldives will lose. If Maldives will lose, how can we evacuate Maldivians to be in other countries? For this, we have to establish international mechanism. Insurance for loss and damage. We need to have an international mechanism that ensure vulnerable people to be safe at that time if temperatures increase. Even for Timor-Leste, if Timor-Leste will lose land, then we will ask international insurance mechanism to address this issue by allocating some amount of money for us to take in adaptation actions.
Augusto Mario Pinto, Timor-Leste's director of the National Directorate of Environment as well as the State Secretary for Environment, is also highly concerned about global warming and strongly believes in the necessity of cooperation between governments and people of all nations to overcome the climate change challenge.
If only several countries protect and conserve environment, but the other groups, they still destroy, then I think it doesn't make sense because the issues are still there. And climate change issues will come up because, once you're talking about the environmental issues or climate change, it's borderless. So if any air pollution in Australia, it's not mean that only in Australia will get impact, but Timor-Leste can get impact, Indonesia can get impact, or Pacific countries also can get impact. So we need to think that environmental is not only responsibility for local people or for one single country, but this is our responsibility. So people in this world, we need to be together, not only thinking about the economic situation. We need to think globally, but we should act locally. This is very important thing. Otherwise, you just talk and talk, but if you do not act locally, then the issue is still there.
Timor-Leste is taking various actions and is employing a number of different policies to tackle the issue of global warming. Mr. Soares Barbosa now provides more details.
The government has established two directorates as part of institutional arrangement to address climate change issues. First directorate is a national directorate for the environment, and then second directorate is national directorate for international environmental affairs. Those two directorates are assigned by the government of Timor-Leste to formulate programs and action plans to address climate change issues at national level. And at the same time, those two directorates are working together with other related ministries at national level to formulate appropriate plan of actions to address climate change issues for now and for the future. Second is the government of Timor-Leste ratified the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change in 2006, and it came into force in 2007. And then thirdly, the government of Timor-Leste also ratified Kyoto Protocol in 2008, and it came into force in January 2009. And then fourth step of the government of Timor-Leste to address climate change issues is that the government is currently developing a national policy on the environment that covers all related issues regarding climate change. And fifth commitment of government of Timor-Leste is that we are developing our own national strategic planning for 20 years that will be approved by the Council of Ministers by the end of this year. This covers everything related to adaptation, mitigation, capacity building, and also financial resources that we are requiring to address climate change adaptation and to adopt some sort of new technology to address climate change issues in various sectors. And sixth, the government of Timor-Leste is working closely with international communities. We are developing our national adaptation program of actions to address climate change issues. The project is undergoing. So the aim of this project is to identify, to prioritize the needs of adaptation measures that could be made, could be implemented by the government of Timor-Leste at national level, so that our community could adapt to the climate change impact that we are facing now in terms of climate change impact to the agriculture sector. Climate change is faced by water resources and other related issues in terms of food security and health as well. Even infrastructure. We involve all those stakeholders together so that we make our national planning to address climate change adaptation. And then the next commitment is that we are going to have a national report on climate change. We call it Initial National Communication to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Then the last commitment, we are promoting solar panel use. We are promoting a biogas project. We are promoting a hydro power project. And we are promoting also wind power projects in various locations in Timor-Leste that could generate electricity to our rural communities. But at the same time, there will be no emission.
To close, our sincere thanks, Secretariat of State for Environment, Adao Soares Barbosa, and Director of the National Directorate of Environment and State Secretary for Environment, Augusto Mario Pinto, for taking time from your busy schedules to discuss Timor-Leste's national response to climate change, and we wish you and all the citizens of Timor-Leste the brightest of futures. For more details on the nation of Timor-Leste, please visit www.gov.east-timor.org. Through encouraging the gentler care of our planet and compassionate living, all nations of the world can work together to quickly overcome climate change. Gracious viewers, thank you for joining us today on Planet Earth, our loving home. Coming up next is enlightening entertainment, right after noteworthy news. May your days be filled with sunshine and much love.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/PE.